Hello everyone, hope all of you are doing well and safe. So I'm gonna make show you how to make kingfish masala. So basically this masala is multi-purpose. Once you make this, you can actually use it for eating it with steamed rice, ghee rice, or appams, roti, naan, whatever. Yeah, so you can have with any of it as a side dish, or you can actually make biryani. So I'm planning to make biryani, but I'll show you how to go about it. So this is the masala that actually needs to be ground in a mixer. So first I've taken 10 green chilies. You can increase, reduce as per your taste. Then a whole garlic, one big piece of ginger, a handful of coriander and mint leaves, then grated coconut, fresh grated coconut, a cup. You can put a sort of a quarter spoon of turmeric, and one tablespoon of red chili powder, one tablespoon peppercorn. Again, you can reduce the red chili and the corn and the green chili if you don't like it very spicy. Then few pods of cardamom, and one tablespoon of fennel seeds. So these are the wet masala. So you can mix all of this and grind in a mixie. You can add a pinch of salt. See, if you've seen, I've put a little salt here because you must remember when you're making biryani, you will have salt in your rice and you will have salt in the fish. Okay, so you're going to put salt and fry the fish. But if you're planning to have this just plain as a masala with all those side, like a side dish, then obviously you can, you know, when you're making it, you can increase the salt as per your requirement. Next, you would also need two big finely chopped sliced onions and one big tomato slice. These you don't have to grind, okay? So this is separate. And when you cut the onion, you can just save a little bit for frying. If you're making biryani, then just, you know, fry some of the onion, a portion of it. So basically all of this combined is just two big onions. So I've taken a portion of it and I've just deep fried for the garnishment and seasoning. Okay, now I'll show you how to go about making the masala. So you need to marinate the fish with like half a teaspoon of turmeric powder, 3 tablespoons of red chili, and salt, required salt. Okay, about, let's say, 1 teaspoon salt should be good enough. And you need to shallow fry in a pan. The fish is being done. This must be what, around 1-1.5 kg of fish, yeah, for 2 cups of rice. Now that's the rice, it's already done. And for the steps how to make the rice, please check out the earlier video which I have posted, the chicken biryani. So it's the same thing. Either you can make the rice in extra water and throw off the water, or you can, you know, use double the quantity of water. So 1:2, 1 cup of rice, 2 cup of water, and then cook for slow cook for 20 minutes, and that's about so. But you can watch the other video where I give you step by step process. So now the fish is done. Fish is good. So what I do is I don't throw away the oil. The extra oil that I get in this pan, I actually fry the onions in the same oil and the masala. So you know, you the flavors are not wasted, and you get that additional flavor in the biryani. As I indicated, I've used the same pan to fry the onions. Onions are nicely caramelized and browned. Once the onion is nice and brown, you add in the tomatoes, the sliced tomatoes. Okay, tomatoes need not be like, you know, fried very well, but just for 5-10 minutes you can saute the, so when the oil starts separating, you can add in the ground masala. So this is the masala that I showed you earlier, and what I did was I also added 3 tablespoons of yogurt, and you can put a little bit of water and also little water in this mixer so that, you know, all the masalas are taken and nothing is wasted. Some people don't like to mix yogurt and fish, so for that, I mean, you can skip the yogurt and instead you can put lime, you know, one whole lime juice while grinding. But otherwise, and if you like lime, then you can also add lime along with the yogurt. So this is the consistency of the masala. Let it cook for around 5-10 minutes till the, you know, the rawness of the ginger, garlic and all, you know, it just goes, and you will see the oil will start separating after about 5-10 minutes. And that's the time when you add in the fried fish. After about 10 minutes, as you can see, the oil has started separating. And throughout the 10 minutes, I have been stirring it, okay? And you need to be very careful that the masala should not burn. So you need to keep stirring. And also keep adjusting the flame. At times you can have like high flame, then medium and then slow. So keep a watch on your masala for about 10 to 15 minutes. So this is very crucial. And also another thing is that after you put the fish, you know, you won't be able to stir the masala and mix the masala as much as you would want to. And unlike when you make chicken or mutton, because, you know, they don't shred, but fish you need to be very careful when you're mixing it. So once, and I had also tasted the salt at this point of time, I added a little bit more. So you need to, you know, basically taste salt, and then once this comes to this stage, you start adding the fish. Problem with fish is, like I said, you need to be very careful. You cannot, like, you know, mix as much as you would want to. So once you put the fish, reduce the flame to absolute low, and then slow cook this till the, you know, the masalas are well incorporated in the fish, and, you know, you can basically slowly just put some masala like that, you know, on top of the fish, just that, and you can cover this and slow cook for a good another 15 minutes or so till, and then you can give it a flip. Okay, so once after like about 5-10 minutes, you can flip the fish so that the other side also gets all the masalas properly, and then I will show you what to be done. The fish is done. Another after 5-10 minutes, this is how it will look. I had flipped it in between, so it's all, the masala is all coated in the fish. Okay, now I've also made half portion of the rice, and I put some saffron soaked in rose water. I put saffron, and I will also put onions, the fried onion that I had shown earlier. So in goes the onion. You can actually also put some mint and coriander. I forgot to keep some aside, so it's okay, I'm going to skip it. And now what you do is remove the fish, okay? Because if you layer the fish as is, when you're serving, the fish will all break up, okay? And if you have guests coming in your house, you don't want to serve. See, it's very soft. So in spite of me being very careful, there are times when the fish breaks, okay? So what you do is just remove only the fish. Try to remove only the fish. Keep them aside in the plate. And the masala, the remaining masala, you will have some broken pieces of fish. That's okay. Put all the masala over onto this rice, okay? And then layer the next layer of rice, put little saffron, the onion, and then put the fish on top, and then do the slow cooking. So when you know, so the fish is intact, and when you serve, the fish will be, you know, you can remove the fish, mix up the rice, and then put the fish back on the serving plate. So you know, you get some whole fish. I'll show you at the end. I've separated the fish, and you can see there are some broken pieces, so that's fine. You just put the masala onto the saffron mixed rice. Take all the masala, don't waste anything. Spread. Just flatten it so that, you know, it's the entire rice gets all the masala. Now empty the remaining portion of the rice. Put the remaining saffron. This actually gives a very nice aroma. You can, some people also mix this in milk, a little milk, yeah, but I did it in rose water. So you see the natural color of the saffron, the yellow, it really comes out well. Now you can put in your onions. Finally, you put in your fish. Now, the fish is coated with masala, and you can just put them over small pieces in center. So now you're rest assured, your fish is intact, okay? And you cover this up, cook, cover this tightly, slow cook for about half an hour, like a dum cooking, very, very slow flame, and your biryani is ready. And once you're, when you're, before serving, what you do is you remove the fish, mix it up nicely with all the masala. And then when you put it in a serving dish, and then you can put your fish on top. Enjoy, guys.